sports. It's in the game.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a shit about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
When you got different views, just know you gon' pay the price. Press up the item you choose.
Ties in the culture, hit you with MK Ultra. I knew you was a vulture. Holy Ghost, get the ushers. No, I can't touch you.
Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay, and this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. Justin Tucker set to boom this one away, and off we go from Lambeau. Taken about 7 yards deep, and this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. They'll run it for the first time with Williams. And right away, they're going to stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
A loss of one brings up third down and 11.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. This will be fielded at the 17. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the Ravens, they'll take over.
At their own 22-yard line.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 22. He'll set up to throw from the gun. He'll find Dobbins out of the backfield. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 3.
For the first time with J.K. Dobbins. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
Well, I can certainly tell my age, partner, because when I was a kid, running backs like J.K. Dobbins with over 2,000 yards in their final season in college, they went early in the draft. Instead, he somehow lasted until the second round. But how great is it to get a guy with that ability who can run it inside, run to the perimeter, and catch the football out of the backfield, be able to get him in the second round? That's what I call a steal.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first down.
Packer pressure, and down he goes. Lamar Jackson, for all the talents of escaping pressure that he possesses, he was helpless to do much of anything there. He had no chance.
And this came from the edge, and those pass rushers, they have so many tricks of the trade to get around blockers. They have a lot of tools in their kit. This was pure speed and athleticism on this play, though. And they could barely get a glove on it before he got the quarterback on the ground.
On third down, Jackson under pressure again, and down he goes again. Just not much a quarterback can do there, CD. The pressure was in his face almost instantaneously, led to a very quick sack. So on fourth down, here's Sam Cook to punt it away. Tyler Irvin back deep. Drive will start from deep in their own territory for the first and 10. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
So how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well,
and maybe you try and find one of those special plays for one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. 11 yards there, first down.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
Now a first down carry, it's Williams. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
This time with Jones. And this will be a Packers first down as good running gets him to about the 44. We're scoreless after one. After the run by Jones, here's 1st and 10. Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked.
Well, the number one mission of any offensive line, you got to protect that quarterback, keep him safe back there. This time, the rush got to him in a hurry.
He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run. Not really any offense for them to speak of here in this first half. Maybe that's what they needed, that big play.
Yeah, it seems that maybe everything changes right there. They've been a little slow out of the gate. We've seen that. But that one big play, that could spark a big burst right here.
Jones with a nice gain there on first down as he takes his forward and call it a pickup of 6.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
From the 24, Rodgers got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Rodgers finding Valdez-Scantling as his guys are first out of the scoreboard here this afternoon.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
And it's good to make it 7-0 Packers. Touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Ravens take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Set at the line for this next drive. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. He finds an opening past the 40. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19.
Pretty ideal right there. Keep it yourself, get the first down, and get the heck out of bounds.
And knowing him, I believe he's thinking, I can get a few more yards if I just lower my shoulder. But he also hears that second voice in his head, his head coach, probably his agent too, saying, get out of bounds, man. Don't do that.
10 yards there, good enough for a Raven first down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
This pass complete. Jackson finding Andrews. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coach's 2-minute drill.
And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to convert by plenty there on 3rd and 1. A nice first down pickup on a gain of 6. Jackson from the shotgun. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
I know we're just in the second quarter and there's a ways to go in this game, but that's a second drop. I'm wondering if that's a little bit of an alarm bell for them when they start calling plays on the offensive side of the ball.
His eyes already looking upfield on that last one before he brought it in. Forced out to his left. Now he'll pull it down. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Looking left side, Andrews with it complete. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the 1st down.
Now despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing 3 there. 2nd down. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on 1st down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open. This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
There's Jackson on 3rd and long. Yeah, he's got it. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson hooking up with Mark Andrews. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am going ahead and tapping out the 1st half.
Well,
there's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
Justin Tucker, the kickoff.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And we're under a minute to go here in what's been an even 1st half, all tied up.
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. A couple completions, you string them together, could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll make it 2nd and a foot or so.
It's 2nd and inches at the 35-yard line.
Rodgers gonna throw. Side by Adams. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the 1st half.
1st and 10 at the 43-yard line.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on 1st down. Here's Rodgers. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. He was looking for his tight end, Jay Sternberger, there. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
Looking at the ball. 18. Get 300. Get 300.
to throw again. Rodgers. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. He was looking for his tight end, Jay Sternberger, there. And it's third down.
And 10 yards to go.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. That's caught. It's Robert Tonyan, the tight end. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room.
First and 10 at the 21-yard line.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And the 13-year man puts it through. And the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. So we will not go into the lockers tied. We do have a leader in the clubhouse, so to speak.
Yeah, it's only 3 points. Doesn't seem like much, but it looms big the way that they got it done right before the half ended.
Taken in at the 3. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. Set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. This taken in about 4 yards deep, and no fireworks to start the half. This will be a touchback. Set at the line for this next drive. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Here's Snead as they run the jet sweep. And this will be taken across midfield and into Green Bay territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Well, they gave up a few yards there, but all in all, I think that's a pretty nice job defensively against the jet sweep. If they don't slow him up, he might take it to the house, so they'll take that play every time on the defensive side of the ball. Oh, what are we doing?
Four yards remain for 2nd down. Now Jackson. It's brought in here by Willie Snead. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a 1st down. Throwing is Jackson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hand.
And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. Za'Darius Smith giving him once again his 3rd sack of the afternoon. Now after that sack, it's 3rd and long for Jackson and the Ravens. And that is incomplete.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
Now Justin Tucker. He has hit from 61 in his career, so he has the leg for this. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle, and that will knot us up at 10. So they come away from this opening drive of the third quarter with only three, but it does draw them even.
Yeah, and that has to be job one, doesn't it? A touchdown definitely would have been nice. We know that. But here, you get back on even terms, and now you've got most of the second half to try and get yourself into a position to win.
About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Running on first down is Jones, but he's not going to get much. Maybe a couple. And it's second down. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. Again, it's Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled them with the inside run.
That good for 22 and a first down. One thing that's great about watching him run, Charles, he doesn't hesitate. He got to the left side of his O-line and just went.
So there's two ways to look at that. One, just absolutely unconcerned, just takes off and goes. But more the latter, I think, which is he has absolute confidence in the guys in front of him, the guys doing the blocking for him. He just takes it and goes with abandon.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
It's a loss of two. Brings up second and 12 at the Ravens.
On second down, Williams. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Try and run for it with Jones. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on third down. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Rodgers gives this to Jamal Williams. He's got the first down inside the 10 and all the way down to the 5.
This is our time.
18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the first three quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, if they want to ride him down the stretch, he should have fresh legs.
Only a yard that time, second and goal.
Brings up second and goal.
They'll try again with Jones. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. And no movement for the field goal unit to break this tie. They're going to go for this thing. Fourth and goal, here we go. They go for it on fourth and goal, but that winds up incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Ravens come up big down at their own goal line. The The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. We'll see if they can grab the lead. Either way, what a job their defense did to force the turnover on downs to set up this opportunity. On the tackle that time, Dean Lowry. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Looking to throw on second down, Jackson. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
Press coverage on the outside, and for defenders, that's the ultimate risk reward. If you take the risk, can you reward yourself by keeping him on the line of scrimmage? But no, not on that one. Got the step on him. Now it's just a matter of laying the ball out there for him to go get it.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Dean Lowry, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. Now Jackson. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. Back-to-back big plays defensively. First the sack. Now they force the incompletion on third and long. Things looking pretty good for them.
And this is where they have to be careful because they've got the momentum going their way. They will be really amped up to get to the quarterback. Look out. Draw, screen, something that can be used against them.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
And that'll be a return of 12 following a very nice punt. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10.
Their own 33-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They need to get this around the 40 on the other side to get into field goal range. Look at the clock, a decent amount of time here in a tie game. What do they do?
No panic situation at all. They got to get a couple of chunk plays, pick up nice bits of yardage.
Target the sidelines?
Target the sidelines because you want to get out of bounds and make sure that clock stops. Because if the clock stays running, that makes things that much tougher for you. It can always bleed out on you.
And he's taken down inside the 30. They get 17 more on that one and another first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now a 10 carry, here's Williams. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. The Packers gonna use one of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. Rodgers to throw. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
Incomplete. Intended for Mercedes Lewis. He was covered by Patrick Queen.
They'd love to get a little closer if they need to kick the field goal on fourth down. From this spot, it's 46 yards. On third down, here's Williams. And he will not get what he needed as he stops short of the first down at around the 22. And they're going to get the timeout called. What a finish. We're down to 4 seconds to go in this football game. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call.
Yeah, we dominate.
So the game here hangs on the right foot of Mason Crosby. He made his only attempt earlier. This for the win. And his kick is good. And the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. A little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football at the end. Just take care of it, and victory was theirs, and that's exactly what they did.
for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Packers are winners here as we say so long from Lambeau.
Party going up, a champ with the crown.